Hello, my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Wednesday, May 18th, 2011. This is your New York session video technical briefing. It's a video review of some of the price action we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. First, let me remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations, but we do provide real time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. And we remind everyone that past trading performance does not predict future results. Do not trade money you cannot afford to lose. What you now see is a 15-minute chart without indicators for the Euro-USD currency pair, as that chart looked at 9:30 a.m. New York time on GFT's The Book 360 trading platform. Now, I've got this chart zoomed out to show price action since 10 a.m. New York time yesterday. You can see here on the upper right-hand portion of the chart, the euro has been steadily drifting lower since the open of today's London session, but it is hard to ignore the multiple sources of prospective support this pair has reached over the past hour. You've got a weekly central pivot point at 1.4208, a daily central pivot point parked just below the psychological level at 1.42. I represent that psychological level with a thin horizontal blue line. And if I conduct a Fibonacci study of the move up from yesterday's low, which you can see in the lower left-hand portion of the chart, a Fib study from there to today's high thus far, which I'm circling near the top of the chart, I find that the 50% Fib retracement level of that move up, 50% Fib represented by the horizontal lime green line that I'm pointing to now, that 50% Fib is sitting between those two pivot points. And by the way, the 50% Fib, very popular, I should say, amongst traders who use Fib levels. And if all of that weren't enough, closer inspection of price action over the past several days reveal even more clues to this 1.42 area. Let's take a look at an hourly chart. This one-hour chart shows price action since last Wednesday, May 11th. Now, I'm going to connect the two swing highs identified with blue circles with one trend line and then draw a separate trend line connecting the two swing highs I've identified on this chart with two red circles. These two trend lines are also prospective sources of support and both seem to be positioned in the 1.42 area, which you can see on the right-hand portion of the chart. Okay, let's get back to that 15-minute chart. Now, do you recall my comment earlier about time of day? I said that it is 9:30 a.m. New York time. This has been a very common time for a move on the dollar to get going, specifically a move on the Euro-USD. So, plenty of reasons to go long at or maybe just above 1.42, the psychological level. If you took the shot, you are long somewhere in this area in here. Your stop loss could be initially positioned 50 pips below your entry for catastrophic protection purposes, and your worst case exit strategy could be to close a trade if the euro dips below this horizontal blue line that I'm pointing to now. That blue line at 1.4184 represents the 61.8% Fib retracement level of the move up from yesterday's low to today's high thus far. It wasn't crazy to move your stop loss to break even when your trade gets to the point where it's 20 pips in profit, which it was during this candle that I'm pointing to now. As you can see now, over time, the euro moved higher, and a logical target for this trade was the daily R1 pivot point at 1.4275, which I'm pointing to now with the blue arrow near the top of the chart. The euro reached that level, that daily R1, about 20 minutes before London close. London close is represented by the vertical red line on the right-hand side of this chart. Again, long trade entry at or just above 1.42 in this area here, and exit at R1. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Wednesday, May 18th.